What's up, guys? We are here with some more heat on the OU ladder. One of my subs asked me if I could make a team around Pangoro for OU Live for the Hot Spicy Meat series. And his birthday was on the 18th. I already wished him happy birthday. I hope you had a great birthday, my man. Hope you examined well everything. He said, yeah, Pangoro is a favorite one from X and Y. So I whipped some heat up. The team is honestly not that good, but it's a lot of fun. So we will hop into showdown and you guys will see it. Okay, here we go. So this team is really wild. We have Asalva's Guzzler with Rock Slide, which is basically my Zardwife check. This team gets murdered by Zardwife if it takes any damage. We have Spiritune, because I was like, I already have this Pangoro that I started with, right? Choice Banner Pangoro. And I already have, I added this Guzzler for more heat, right? So I was like, let's add a third dark type for that ultra heat. And for that checking mana gem, I put Spiritune. And it's a rest talk set. And we have this Landorus set that Ray Scarfa is used in SPL, which is Protect to stay healthy. Yeah, you guys will have seen it. It was also used in OST by Malekith. This Leftovers McNeil Pinspill to check type of Lily, and just in general, because we have three dark types that get destroyed by fairy types, I put in this McNeil to have like, at least something for fairies. And we have Porygon Z with the MC conversion, Ghost as a win condition, and T like told me to put this on because it's like one of his favorite mons. And I was thinking we probably should have a Scarf on this team because this team is slow as fuck, but I was like, it's just grab again, have some heat, because I was like, this team is just for fun. Like, if I want to make this team good, I would have to change so much. So Guzzler is pretty cool in this game. Kind of lead up with Guzzler, but let's just lead up with Bennett Pangoro, because, oh yeah, it's called Happy Birthday Eddie, by the way. So this is kind of bad matchup. Pretty sure I will just get blown away by Steam Eruption. Yeah, so if this is a Zemo Volcano, I have a big problem here. I will just go into my AV Guzzler, I guess. Too bad I didn't lead with it. There's Earthquake. Okay. Why do you go for Earthquake? I could have lived that and killed him. So what would you switch into Guzzlord? I guess he could just stay in. I'm gonna just drop a Draco, like he doesn't have good switch-ins for that. Goes for Steam Eruption that does pitiful damage. He burns me as per usual. Pokemon is a good game. If he didn't burn me, I could have potentially killed him with Earthquake. Never mind, he has a Citrus Berry. well, this sucks a lot. So we already know he's not choice. He's some super weird set. And Maestro Draco is not gonna do much. I'm gonna just throw in my Spiritune now, because I don't think he can do that much. Looking at that, he's some weird mixed set. I can call him up on this and attempt to go for game. As yeah, see, that doesn't do that much. Now I can rest. And if I'm gonna go hard cure him here, something like that. We left the Fire Blast and we can go for Sleep Talk, hopefully pull a Command or a Dark Pulse. Let's see, that Fire Blast didn't do much, we get a rest. KK. Not surprised that we get a rest, it's Pokemon after all. Yeah, my man had to wait till I... Yeah, it took me long to record this heat live. He told me he wants some edits in this, I will see what I can do, but since I want to get this video up today and I don't want to take forever to get it up, I probably don't have that many edits, because editing takes like extra 1 hour, like just rendering take extra 1 or 2 hours, and editing itself, just I will just put some clips in, like that won't take that long, maybe like a few minutes. The thing is, I have to find clips that are fitting and that are good as we pick up his Volcanion. I would rather have pulled a Coleman there, but it's fine. Dennis Lantern, by the way, my nicknames are awful probably. I know I went Thunderous, unless he's like banking on me pulling a rest here. That Thunder did nothing, good god, we eating those up and we get a rest. So if he's Nasty Plot, we're in a bad position here, because I'm forced to rest and he misses a Thunder, amazing. I mean, that wouldn't have killed anyway, like without a crit, but Zemove would have killed me. I would have expected this to be Zemove, but he can still go for it. Let's go for another Sleep Dog. He's Skydrop. I hope we can put in some work with Pangoro this live and with Guzzlord. I will put a replay at the end with where Guzzler puts in some Moorhook. That was really fun. Okay, we got a Calm Mind, which is nice. This guy does lawful damage. I don't think this guy really has a good team. We are not high on the ladder. I just made this. I mean, you all hot spicy meat, because the series is called like this, and yeah, I feel like I've kind of, this name feels like stolen, because some other people use this name for their alts or something. Like, not the exact name, but kind of like that. Bengay has used alts pretty similar to this, and I think Tombaugh uses that word sometimes, but Man Padlop just, when I was looking for a series for his name, Man Padlop just told me to call it that, and he just, we didn't find a better name, and he kept telling me that. He even made a comment in my video after telling, oh, Hydroconan, yeah, this guy's some weird in-game team, and he just forfeits. And we got our first points on his account, and my account is not even registered yet. But yeah, if I go like high on the ladder with this team, I will get just get demolished, because like I literally don't have checks for most meta. Like I just rely on Lannis and Magina check stuff most of the time. And if I would take this team a bit more serious, I would delete one of these three dark types and put a Scarf Kelly on. Oh, my opponent has Bengo, that's funny. Have fun, my man. You don't see Bengo that often, and we have both have one. I guess that's why we go on a low ladder, so we get that juicy mirror match. Yeah, I could see him leading with the obvious Ninetales, or with his Stealth Rocker, which would be the Probo path. So that's probably Mega Venusaur. I don't know why he's a Kingdra when he doesn't have rain. Maybe he's that crit Kingdra set, but it's low ladder, so I shouldn't ask questions. Oh, we have AoE Sludge Rift, by the way, and Guzzlord, so we can live in Moonblast. It's funny. Oh, yeah, fine. I thought I've changed the set. Yeah, I changed it to Rock Slide at first. I forgot what I had. Yeah, I don't really know what to lead. Probably Magina. Overall has a good matchup. Whereas most of his team, if I can fire off, I don't have Flashkin. Rip. Rip, this sucks. I was faster too. Yeah, I kind of want to make this assault with, you know, max special attack, because this is like more bulky with leftovers and ice beam. Like, this is a Bengay spread. We will just go Pango. I assume he's gonna go for rocks. So we can fire off a superpower slash. What typing is this thing? I can't see it because my recording program is in the way of the typing. It's like steel and something, but I will just go for. No, he doesn't have superpower switches. Like, he has a Venusaur, but yes, he goes to an Ninetales. This is gonna get blown away. He predicted knockoff, probably. This gets bopped. Shoutouts to Eddie. We get the kill. And now you can go into Venusaur. Or, yeah, that was. He could have gone Kingdra or Helmflame too. Man, this is basically free Magearna slash Guzzlord, but I'm gonna go Magearna, and he misses a Leech Seed, and I can go for a slow Volt Switch here. Oh yeah, this team also doesn't have Hazard Control, that's another big problem if you face Hazard stack. Maybe we should have gone for Ice Beam. We get a slow Volt Switch though, and we can go Pangoro here. He doesn't seem to be Mega, so Pangoro or, yeah, I wanna go Pangoro. Be icy, this thing gets another kill. We see if he's leftovers. He's leftovers, so we can go for knockoff slash ice punch. I wanna go for knockoff because basically hits everything. Ice punch, I don't know if it would have killed, that did a good chunk. He goes for Leech Seed. If he's protected, it's gonna be a bit annoying, but like, yeah, knocking off is the right play. He doesn't have switch into this. Like, he can go in his own Pangoro, but he will lose his item in the process. I don't even know what this guy's Z-move mon is, if he even has a Z-move mon. Maybe it's Z-move Talonflame. Yeah, it looks to be Z-move Talonflame. That's, that has 5 million, and we can go into defensive Landorus here, and we can potentially go for Protect on a Z-move. On the next turn, if he goes for SD this turn, he just goes for Acro. I'm just go for Rocks, because he had minus 1, so Z-move is not going to do that much. He goes for Roost. And I can't really touch this, because I don't have Stone Edge. Since Talonflame is not common in this meta, you don't run that, and like HP is way more nice, like way more common. It's nice to hit opposing Landorus, Zygarde, all that stuff. He just forfeits, even though I didn't have anything to hit him. And yeah, let's just look for another one. This is gonna be chill. We face another executive. We have monograss. Okay, maybe I should have gotten some points. Okay, this guy just forfeits. Yeah, that is nice because I want to get some at least somewhat serious battles. Like, nah, it's this life is all about fun, but it would be nice if they have somewhat of an idea of what they are doing. I used this team on the 1300s, and that was really the other day, and I was like struggling. I was like going, I think 1-1 or 1-2. Well played, Zadwa just completely destroys this team, because if they switch out on Guzzlord, knowing the focus blast doesn't kill, I basically have to bank on them staying in. Like, if they switch out and come back in later when my Guzzlord is weakened, I just have to sack with the Zard every time. I basically just lose. My only play is setting up the Porygon before the Zard comes in. This guy probably leads with Infernape. I'm gonna just lead Landorus like a tryhard. It could be HPIs, which would be dope for him, but I'm gonna just go for rocks because we see a Zard on the other side and he doesn't have hazard control unless he's Defog Zard or Defog Scyther, which is weird but could be an option. But yeah, this guy's basically 3 rock weak mon, so why would I not go for my rocks? This guy's using some heat. Good god, the low ladder showing me how it's done. They're trying to out heat me. So HPI probably doesn't do much to this. I'ma just go Magearna here, or Porygon. Not Magearna. I don't know why I said Porygon, that's not an option. Like, we'll see if he has Defog or if he's SD. Okay, he goes for knockoff. There go my lefties. Shout out Padlop. Nice nickname. Padlop is ranked number 5, by the way, in the OUPL ranking for Sunmoon. Not for Sunmoon, for Aurus OU. That's funny as fuck. The OUPL auction is later on today. I don't know if you guys are following OUPL, it's gonna be hype. Hope my man Padlop gets drafted. Hope my man Sorry gets drafted, and who else? I don't know if anyone else of my friends signed up for that. But yeah, I'm gonna go for Ice Beam here. Yeah, yes, Defog Scyther, I expect this kind of. That did nothing, but I'm gonna go for Slow Volt Switch. As I guess he could go, but nah, he wouldn't go Stunfisk because I just showed him that I have Ice Beam. Struggle Bug, what the fuck is that? He lowered my special attack. Super weird. Yeah, I can go from, I can set up my Porygon here basically. I don't think he would be max speed. It would be nice to have Rocks up because I could actually sweep if I had Rocks up. But he goes for Roost, T with Bling on the cut, let's go. And I'm gonna just go for T-Bowl here. I don't know if Shadow Ball kills if he's bulky. Bug and flying, yeah. Let's T-Bowl this. Bop! I don't know if the crit matter, probably not. Unless he's some pretty bulky AV set. Stunfisk is gonna get blown away by Shadow Ball. It could live on, probably like A. 50, good god, is he a Solvest? Solvest T-Wave, this guy's. No, it's not. Obviously not a Solvest if it's T-Wave. But it's really Spadef, so this guy has the tech. I should still outspeed him. Para got nerfed this gen, so my speed is only lowered by 50%. And we outspeed him, and we don't get the potential roll. He doesn't recover though. He's just banking for the full power to get more damage on me. I hope we get this off, amazing. So I don't think he has anything to kill me from this range with my defense boost, and this maybe Zard Y. I just hope I can get off more damage. I could see him go for rocks. This is his only potential rocker besides Stunfisk. I thought Stunfisk was his rocker, but he didn't go for rocks. He just wanted damage. I don't know if he went for U-turn on a threat. I would have gone for Flare Blitz. I guess he wants to sack his Glatheon. That's fine. I'm gonna go for recover on this, because if I get the opportunity to, why not? I'm still faster. Rip. I guess I should have attacked. Oh, he goes for hail. That's a bit annoying. Hopefully no full para here. Yeah, okay, we're getting pretty lucky here, no game parrot. Dang. Yeah, I'm gonna let up a bit until we get a decently. Unless we like, I at least wanna face one team that is not complete weird. I wanna face one real team. Flabbits kills us, dang. So maybe it's Adamant Zard, or maybe that's just the power of Zardex. I'll just go land and get my rocks here. Actually, I have no reason not to click Earthquake, so there's no point in really getting a rocks at this point of the game. Yeah. If you are in the Den of Thieves chat, you will know the reference of this nickname. it's like a prank. I don't know if I can make it public. But yeah, you guys can join my chat if you like decent at building. It's always nice to build with friends. And I mean, I don't know you obviously if you just join, but some of the people that, like, the chat was there, like, I was introduced to the chat like 1 year ago, and I didn't have YouTube back in the day, so like, I found there some nice people, and then I just added some people myself, and it's pretty chill group on Skype. I don't know why we're not on Discord for some reason. Some people don't use Discord, but yeah, Kaldi, let's just go hard McGina here. Dang, I don't even know if I should upload this, because these guys are obviously like not having, these guys obviously have like weird teams. Like, my team is pretty tryhard compared to these weird teams that they have. Even though my team is not tryhard. Yeah, we floor can pick off the Kelly. I will just go for slow vault here, sack of Magina. I'm not really about preserving, and I'm gonna try to get a Pengar probably dies, but I'm gonna try to get a kill with Pengar. It dies obviously to a CC, but if he's like Scarf, if he's Scarf, he can't kill me. Might as well try. He does have my punch. We eat that up. I don't know why he didn't go for CC. We don't get a kill because he's Sash. I'm gonna preserve this Pengar because it's Eddie's. This video is for Eddie, and yeah, I don't know if this is his real name or if he's only called that on YouTube. Yeah, shoutouts to you, and we just go for it, Earthquake. I hope we get a decent opponent next. Like, I don't want to face like super tryhard, but like at least an okay team, not some wild, unexperienced opponent with like not even one real Pokemon in this team. Okay, that is exactly what I'm talking about. This guy is tryhard. Okay, now I kind of regret what I said. I'm gonna get blown away by this. At least we have a Medichamp check, and we kind of have a Greninja check in Magina. Greninja's getting overwhelmed though. It's like Greninja, not Greninja, Magina has to check Greninja, and Lilith is the game. What we can do here is can just lead with Pangoro. He's leading with Landorus slash Scolipede in my opinion. Yeah, I'm gonna just go for Ice Punch. I'm not predicting much. This is his Rocker. Damage on this would be nice. Just like, I don't think we can Oko if he's max defense. Yeah, that's bulky Landorus. He's faster for some reason. I'm adamant Pengar, that's probably why. They're on HPI, so I don't want to go to my own Lando. I'm gonna just Ice Punch again, it's fine. Even though this gives him a free Keldeo, if I switch out, he gets momentum. He lets the Medicham take damage, which I'm fine with. That did a lot. And yeah, my only switch into this is my Spiritomb. I forgot the name for a second because I never used this Pokemon. As he goes for High Jump Kick when I have a Spiritomb, interesting choice, and he just drops. Okay, see. Greninja is a threat. I could see this being the Ash Grin. Oh, yeah. Guzzlord can also check Ash Grin, but yeah, Magina is my switch in. Because it can also check the Protein Ice Beam variants decently well. And I don't see what I lose from clicking. I don't have Volt Switch because his Landorus doesn't die. I don't have Rocks up, so. I want to Flurkin here, Ice Beam. I want to Flurkin. So he goes Scolipede. Okay, that didn't go too well. He gets some nice chip. We go for Slow Volt Switch here. He goes for SD. Yeah, this is where we don't have a Scarf, but this is where it comes in play. Because if he's the Z-move set, actually I can go into my Landorus and I can protect T on a potential Z-move. The thing is, even if I protect, I think he still kills me. Probably still kills me next turn. Yeah, he goes for Z-move, I predicted that. How much does it do? Okay, that's nothing, amazing. Okay, now I'm free to go for my Rocks or for Earthquake. I should go for Earthquake since he's gonna 2-hit KO me otherwise. Yeah, we get rid of the Scolipede. So yeah, Protect Land was showing where it's a good set. Can able to like get, if he spikes here, he's a god, but I'm just protecting. Yeah, this set is really cool for opposing Lando to protect on his Z-move. I don't have a good switch. I'm gonna go into my Guzzlord, the god. I'll save my Landorus as fodder. And look at that nice chip damage. I see a Tapu Lele, so I wanna go for Sludge Wave. If I'm him, I just sack the Landorus. As he goes hard, Tapu Lele predicted. Let's get some of his damage on this. 59, okay, a bit disappointing. But yeah, I go Magearna here. And no special attack drop. We can go for another Flora Cannon. Yup. HP fire, we eat that, don't miss. And we miss X. It's good, it's all good. It's Pokemon. If I can hit this, that would be nice. We can hit, nice. Tapu Lele is gone. Get a Soul Heart boost. And I think he's gonna go Keldeo Greninja. Now you can go to all three mons, everything else beats Magearna. But if I'm lying, I'm gonna go Keldeo probably. His choice Keldeo is nice, because he can't go for a Sacred Sword, because a Sacred Sword, however the move is called, I mix those up sometimes. He can't go for fighting move because of Spirit Tomb, and if he goes for a water move, Guzzlord comes in. And yeah, this guy just forfeited, so I will grab like one or two more games. I don't want to make this too long, but it's only 21 minutes. For my man. As we see, yeah, this guy is, I don't want to say trial, but like more standard team. You know, Terrakion is not common, so that's probably Scarf Terrak to check Volk. If this guy knows how to team build. And Orlando is the rocker. The zone could be AV, and could be both Zards. I think it's Zard Y. I want to leave a Guzzlord here to be H. Yeah. I just want to drop Draco or Sludge Wave. I don't know if I want to drop Draco because he's a Feeny. I don't want to give him free rocks. Like, yeah, I'm gonna just drop Draco. If he goes Feeny, go play. But if he stays in, I don't want him getting away with free rocks. If he is, he can go for U-turn. What am I saying? He can go for U-turn. He outspeeds me. He can go for U-turn. So let's Sludge Wave here. Exactly, because he can U-turn into his Tapu Fini / Tangrowth. Hopefully the cancel button works. Exactly, nice chip on the Fini, and that didn't do much. I don't have good switch-ins to this. Magearna is gonna take an Edge's Madness. Okay, now line, and now I kinda wanna go for Ice Beam because he has a Landorus, but I'm a Volt. Cause he should go Magnezone. Exactly. And we can bring out our, and if he's fast, Pagnaro is slower. But this is like one of my only opportunities to bring up Pagnaro. This team is way too slow. I have to change a lot of on this team if I wanna make it serious. I'm gonna go for Ice Punch or Knockoff. Yeah, Ice Punch seems fine. As, yeah, I didn't think about the Tapu Fini, I just thought about Landorus. So Gunk Shot, that would have been a god play. Yeah, okay, I'm not playing this well. I played okay, but this team just isn't that good. And I'm gonna go for Ice Beam this time. In case he wanted to go Landorus on a Volt Switch. Just goes Magnezone makes the correct play, but I can Pain Split on this. Yeah, this is bad though. Let's get this Pain Split off, and then we can Volt next turn. I can try to switch. Yeah, but it doesn't work, and he gets the element that wasn't a roll. Yeah, this is bad. I can set up with my Porygon, but I don't have rocks up. Should have gone rocks up first. But this is like a good opportunity to set up. He's probably AV Tang, but there's not much that AV Tang can do to me, because I don't have an item that he can knock off, and I'm a plus one defensive, and there's a 2-hit KO him, yeah. That drop doesn't matter. Knockoff does some chip, but nothing crazy. But yeah, imagine I had rocks up now. Pretty much would have won the game almost. Yeah, not almost, would have won the game. Scarf Rex still outspeeds me. Okay, Sex of the Fiend to get some regen. Wait. I can recover. No, this has not just madness. There's no point in him to recover. But yeah, I will Kalk if he comes out with Terrakion, but I don't know what he's doing. He's just letting everything take damage. This is not the way how to play with this Porygon. You should have just sacked either the Tangle or the Fiend. Now he let the Fiend take damage and sack the Tang, but this is still a fodder for him, I guess. Yes, Terrakion could be Cigar, so let me Kalk how much that does. Porygon. It's Tarak or your choice Garf, Stone Age this. If I'm at plus one defense, it does 55, so you would have to be Z-move to kill me. And how much does a Shadow Ball do? I don't know, I'm just gonna click it. Because if I switch out, I lose my boost. He's Scarf, you eat that up. I could have even gone for Recover, but that would risk me getting crit. We got rid of the Scarf Shrek, amazing. Yeah, if I just was a bit more patient and got up rocks first, this probably would have swept them, but pretty sure Zard can live a hit from full. But yeah, just damage on Zard is always nice, because Zard is a big threat to this team, no matter if it's X or Y. Zard X might die to this, actually. I don't think that mattered, because if he's no HP, amazing. Yeah, I will grab one last one. Hopefully this is not a downfall. Oh god, he has a Dougie, and this guy, this looks like a serious team, kind of. Yeah, I'm gonna lead Lando. If he leads Gwen, good play. Leads Beedrill, like a lot of people do, just to get off the Mega, and so we get our rocks early. Helmet would be nice to get Chip here, but we are obviously lefties, and wait, doesn't this win the game? Spiritomb? No, it doesn't 6-0, but Spiritomb just puts in work. If he spikes Rubin, though, that's annoying. Yeah, I'm gonna go to Spiritomb. We will see if he spikes. I will play accordingly. Keith rocks. I mean, it could be double hazard, but I'm attempt to call my. Could be fast. Did he go for Whirlwind? Yeah, okay, Keith. So just going for. Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. Not having hazard control sucks a lot if he spikes and. Okay, he's not. Okay, I'm just HPS breaking Whirlwind. That's the only reason I'm staying in. He could Roost you, obviously, but yeah, exactly. He predicted a Whirlwind. And Coleman predicting a Roost here. Brave Bird, okay, my Dark Pulse. Coleman puts me in a good position versus Coco. And versus Greninja. Okay, we got rid of the Skarm, nice. Damn, if I go unrefeated with this team, I know it's a little lad and didn't get real opponents really, but still that would be fire. I'll just Dark Pulse this as he goes for U-turn. Does a good chunk, and Latios is probably gonna die to this. Yup! Okay, that could have mattered. Probably didn't matter, cause I mean, Latios has decent speed death, so it could have mattered, I'm not sure. I'm attempt. I can't rest on this because it's electric terrain. This range, we take a hit from Beedrill still. We don't have good switch in, so I'm gonna just sack this then. He goes for Z move. Oh my god. Gigavolt Havoc kills me. Yeah, okay, I didn't have to switch into that. I mean, I could have gone to my Guzzy, but Guzzy, good god, what did I call it that? But if he's like. He's Dazzling Gleam, that's not an answer. So I'm gonna go to this and go for Flurkin. He can't go Hard Doggy unless he dodges. He goes Hard Doggy, hopefully. If I miss this, I'm gonna be pissed. Okay, and amazing, he just sacks his Doggy. Now he can't drop my Magearna, and this can still check the Greninja, kind of. Yeah, can obviously still check. And he just forfeits, so we go undefeated with this weird ass team, but yeah, the ladders. But we at least had 1, 2, 3 decent Leo. Kind of decent teams on the other side, but they didn't play them too well. Thank you guys for watching. Shoutouts to Eddie. Happy birthday again, my man. Even though it's like already over. In German, I would not know how to say, like, what you say when it's a few days after the birthday is already over, what you wish then, but in English, I don't really know that well. But yeah, hope you enjoyed this, and I'll put a little clip at the ending now with a replay. Oh, I almost forgot that. Let me do that real quick. And yeah, stay tuned for OST that will be coming next days. Monday next week, we have more OST semifinals, and yeah, that's hype. And thank you guys for watching. I'm Doc Rich, signing out, and wish you guys a fantastic day. Peace out.